meeting new creatures at each place that he stops. From every encounter, he learns lessons about himself, his beloved Rose, the stranded pilot, and the universe at large. When I went to a jazz band festival last year, the director there gave me a similar name to Little Prince. He nicknamed me Xena the Warrior Princess. To blend these two ideas, my credo will be more of a story rather than a list of beliefs or an essay. This is the story of Xena the Warrior Princess, inspired by both my own life experiences and the story of the Little Prince. Xena the Warrior Princess was born into a world of color and light. Everywhere she looked, love surrounded her. Initially, living in the castle with her royal family was all that she needed. Xena was satisfied with her sister, mom, dad, and dog. This family was all that she had ever known. One day, though, she woke up with a yearning for more. Yes, her family was safe and comforting, but she knew deep inside herself that there was more beyond her castle that she had to explore. At night, she would often gaze out of her window, wondering what was out there, knowing that she was meant to take a journey far from the stability of her home. One day, Xena did just that. She first found herself on a very dark planet. The pitch black film surrounded her. She could do nothing but blindly reach out in front of her and squint, hoping to somehow regain her vision. Alas, her surroundings remained completely dark. She had never been more lost in her entire life. Just as she was beginning to doubt her foolish decision to journey far from home, a singular, clear pitch ran out from the silence. Xena called out to the sound, knowing that it would respond to her. Sure enough, the note replied. The sound illuminated her heart brighter than any light bulb could have. As Xena sang, the sound came back again and again. Then it started to change pitch, creating a haunting yet alluring melody, tangled with Xena's singing. In the darkness, she began to dance and sing, allowing the music to guide her movements. Even if she couldn't see herself, the planet, or where the sound was coming from, she no longer cared because she was making beautiful music. This fueled her. It gave her the strength she needed to continue on her journey. She sang to the planet, thank you for the song. Music is my answer when I am in darkness. Still humming the tune under her breath, she moved on to the next planet. This planet was also very strange, unlike anything she could have imagined. On it was the largest mirror she had ever seen, and a bright spotlight shining straight on her. At the sight of herself in the mirror, Xena cringed. She did not enjoy being so exposed. She wore plain clothing, hair in a messy updo atop her head, with a face that looked tired and stressed. Amidst her discomfort, she heard a small voice. It said, excuse me, but I don't get very many visitors here on my planet, and I'm very excited to see you. Dear, you are quite beautiful. Upon hearing this, Xena became embarrassed. She examined where the voice was coming from. Its source was a small flower, a daffodil. As Xena recoiled in discomfort, the flower began to wilt. Please don't be embarrassed, you're making me wither away, the flower cried. You must find it in your heart to be kind to yourself, or I will surely die. Even though it was difficult for Xena, she managed to look herself up and down in the mirror. Now, tell yourself kind words, my dear. Tell yourself what you would say to someone you deeply love. Xena thought about her sister back at home. What would she say to her beautiful sister? She told herself, Xena, you are worthy of love. Please be kind to yourself. You're a beautiful person, both inside and out. Look at yourself. You're brave enough to go on this journey, and you are growing with every step you take. How incredible is that? The daffodil unfurled its petals, and the color returned to it. Thank you, Xena. Pick me up from the ground and put me in your hair. I will be there to protect you on your journey, princess, as long as you continue to love yourself. With that, Xena took the lovely daffodil and tucked it behind her ear, eager to travel to the next planet. When she arrived at this planet, it was very different from the last two. In the middle of the planet was a gigantic bed with blankets and stuffed animals piled on top of it. It reminded her of her bed at home, but much more softer and comfier. As she looked at the bed, she was very hesitant to touch it, for she did not want to fall asleep. I need to continue my journey, not take a break, Xena thought. There's absolutely no way I have time to stop and rest. Right when she was about to continue on her way, one of the stuffed animals spoke. You look tired. I can see it in your eyes and in your walk. You've traveled such a long way. I admire your perseverance, though you really do need a nap. Xena shook her head in disbelief at the small stuffed animal bear. She slowly turned away from it and began to walk. Wait, the bear called out. It is important to realize how crucial it is to rest, recharge, relax. I know it's fun to go, 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 but it is necessary to give yourself and others time to cool off. Come, lay here. The princess reluctantly obliged, dragging her feet on the way to the bed. Once she lay down under the heap of blankets, clutching the bear to her chest, she realized just how good it felt to take a minute to slow down. She felt her breathing even out and her body release the tension she'd been holding with her the entire journey. Eventually, Zina woke up, stretching her arms to the sky. Smiling to herself, she jumped out of bed, feeling rejuvenated. The bear spoke up. Hey, take me with you. In your life, there will be times when you need a break. There will be times when others need a break. And despite the tiredness, you refuse to take one. Keep me as a reminder that slowing down is okay. The princess hugged the bear to her chest and continued her journey through the galaxy. Next, she arrived at a place entirely different from anything she had seen. In it, there was a herd of elephants gathered around a watering hole. The babies rolled around in the mud while their parents watched, chatting about their children as parents love to do. Instantly, a rush of longing came over Zina. It was the first time on her journey that she truly missed the castle. Seeing the happy community made memories of her own home flood back to her. Before she realized it, tears were streaming down her face. Mother Elephant turned to look at her. There, there, the mother said, wrapping her trunk around Zina's shoulder. I will tell you what I tell all the young children of your planet. Yes, it is okay to cry, but how are we going to feel better? We feel better when we lift others up. Now wipe your tears and come with me. I have a job for you. Zina brushed her fears away and followed the Mother Elephant over to a tree. The Mother Elephant said, this may not seem like a large task to you, but it would mean a great deal to the children playing in the water. On top of the tree, do you see the rainbow ball stuck up there? Our trunks cannot reach it, and an elephant would have a very hard time climbing a tree. Please, can you help us? Zina nodded and began to climb. With each branch she passed, she felt better, knowing that she was doing something worthwhile for the elephant children. It didn't matter that her clothes were getting dirty or her arms were getting tired. She felt happy. Finally, she grasped the ball in her fingers triumphantly. The children gathered around the base of the tree, excited to play with their long-lost toy. Zina threw it down to them as they cheered for her. As the mother smiled at her, Zina realized how wonderful it felt to help other people, even in her own time of sadness. The princess watched the children play with the ball, feeling satisfied that her journey led her to this. Zina closed her eyes, remembering all that she had encountered on her strange but fulfilling journey. She felt ready to go home and share what she learned with her parents, her sister, and her dog, of course. When she opened her eyes, she was back in her bedroom. The song she sang at the first planet was still stuck in her head. The flower was still behind her ear. The bear was still in her arms, and dirt from the tree climbing still clung to her clothes. Smiling from ear to ear, Zina tiptoed downstairs to where her family was in the living room. She gave each of them a long, firm hug without explanation. She was grateful for her journey, grateful to be home, and grateful simply to be alive. Zina, the warrior princess, finally felt complete.